In fact, we're going to return straight to Dale Farm.
I'm just going to give you a brief rundown of the developments this morning. I'm then going to hand you over to Tony Ball, the leader of the council, and also John Barron, the local MP. After they have a few words to say, there'll be time for some questions. I will then hand you over to the Essex Police and the East of England Ambulance Service, who also have a few words to say to you. So, in terms of the progression this morning, consistent attempts have been made both on Tuesday and this morning to negotiate with protesters to leave the site peacefully. It was clear to the council last night that those who wanted to leave the site voluntarily had done so, and those who were left made it clear that they had no intention of cooperating with the council. Police officers entered the Dale Farm site at 7 a.m. this morning following intelligence which informed the commanders that anyone entering the site was likely to come up against violence and a serious breach of the peace would occur. Intelligence received indicated protesters had stockpiled various items with the intent of using these against bailiffs and police. The police will give you more details on this at their briefing in a moment. Electricity was cut off to the site for health and safety reasons. The water has not been cut off. Electric generators are available on site for residents who need electricity for medical purposes. There has been a small number of incidents of fire and pre-existing medical conditions of residents on site, which have been responded to quickly by our fire and health partners. Following the initial wave of extreme resistance and violence from the protesters in the form of missiles, unknown powders, urine, and lumps of concrete, the level of tension has reduced and the council's contractors, assisted by the police, are beginning the process of removing lock-ons at the barricade entrance. I will now introduce you to Councillor Tony Ball and Mr John Barron, the MP for the local area.
I think no one will take any satisfaction out of where we've come, where we've ended up to today. Certainly when I became a councillor, it was never in my mind and never did I want to preside over an operation where we saw riot police on the streets of Basildon. But I'm absolutely clear that after 10 years of negotiation to try and find a peaceful solution to this, that actually what we're doing is the right thing. I think we've seen from the level of violence put up by the protesters this morning that it was absolutely right that the police led the operation. I thank the police for what they've done and I congratulate them on the professional way in which they've carried out the operation. Now it looks as though it might have quietened down a little bit. I now call upon the travellers to ask the protesters to stand down so that the bailiffs can carry on with their lawful work of clearing the site. I'm still hopeful and actually determined that when it comes to site clearance of the travellers, and we know what we can do on certain sites, that this will be carried out in as safe and as dignified a manner as possible. Well, there's no doubt the scenes we've seen of caravans on fire and certain violence put up by the protesters is nothing that we can say we wanted to see. But I do believe that the police and the council's agents have acted with proportionate actions and have acted in a professional manner and as safe a manner as possible. I'm going to ask John Barron to say a few words and we'll take some questions after that.
Just very briefly, just to reinforce what Councillor Tony Ball has said, if we did not take this action, then local residents and the nation as a whole would very clearly ask, why is there one law for travellers and one for the settled and law-abiding community? But I add to what Tony has said, and that is the protesters have made it clear that they are there at the request of the travellers. What we're asking the travellers to do now is to ask the protesters to move off. The violence that we've seen so far has come from the protesters. The police are quite rightly trying to clear the protesters away so we can get on in as peaceful way as possible the site clearance. And this is what this is at the moment. It's a site clearance rather than a forced eviction, and we want it to continue to be that, but we have to get through the protesters first so we can progress that site clearance.
Why is that peaceful clearance involved with being tasered?
Because you've got protesters who have been throwing stones and rocks, walking around
threatening violence with iron bars, that cannot be acceptable. At the end of the day, we want a peaceful site clearance. When you've got protesters threatening violence and throwing stones, then you have to take action. And the police have to maintain as much calm and law and order as possible for the benefit of everyone, not just the bailiffs, not just council officials, but the travellers themselves.
We're being told that people were actually not knocking on the doors, not making clear their intentions, but just moving in and tasing people without the proper warning.
Well, we'd have to actually see whether that was the case. We are not being told that's the case. We're being told that at the end of the day, the police have been pursuing their operation calmly, resolutely, and as safely as possible. But I reinforce the message. When you've got protesters throwing rocks at you, carrying iron bars and using them in a threatening manner, it is absolutely right that the police actually maintains peace and law and order. Otherwise, this could degenerate into a complete bun fight, and that would be to the benefit of no one.
During the riots, people carried iron bars, and they were acting in a threatening manner. They weren't tasered.
Well, all we know is that stones have been thrown, iron bars are being carried in a threatening way, and I'm sure, as Tony will confirm, the police have showed restraint in trying to maintain law and order here, and we fully support them in those actions.
Can I just add to that? What was read out was that the intelligence had been received over the last few days that the protesters who were left were not going to go peacefully and were going to put up violent resistance. It's up to the police to make the area secure so that then the bailiffs can go about their lawful duties of clearing the site. That's when the knocking on the doors comes in and asking the travellers to move off peacefully or engage with the council about their housing options. The protesters are there at the request or behest of the travellers, and they have caused the violence that we've seen today.
Is that why it was a police-led operation as opposed to a bailiff-led operation? Because that's what you always wanted, wasn't it? You wanted the bailiffs to go in first, followed by the police, to make sure law and order was being carried out properly. But obviously, it turned around, it ended up being a police operation supported by the bailiffs.
Absolutely. Right. The risk to the public and to public safety was such that the police felt rightly, and with the support of the council, that they needed to go in first to secure the site before the bailiffs could then go in and work in a safe manner with the travellers. But this is all down to the protesters and the intelligence that have been gathered over the last two or three days.
Sorry, can I
Can you just say when exactly that decision was made to make the police bailiff?
No, I'm not prepared to say that, but it was a recent-ish decision.
Today?
Recent.
You said it's going quiet now. You're moving into the next phase of the operation. What kind of things are we likely to see now?
Okay, these calls will be made by the professionals, not by me, but my understanding is it's gone quieter, which is good, and the operation will now proceed. We will try to secure the gantry and then take the measures that are required to then carry on with the site clearance.
Could I have a question from LBC Radio, please?
How pleased are you with the way that this seems to be coming to an end, this 10-year battle with these troubles?
I'd never use the word please, because I'm sorry it's come to where we are today. But I am satisfied that after 10 years, the council has done all that it can to try and seek a peaceful resolution to this. And actually, the council, the residents of Basildon, and the travellers as well, need to see an end to this after all this time of uncertainty.
The cost of this operation, you've previously put aside £8.5 million of taxpayers' money to pay for this. The policing costs are far bigger, £10 million. How much has been spent so far?
Well, the budget was set there on a worst-case scenario. We're not there. There's been delays, which is of no doubt added to those costs. But there's no doubt that because of the actions of the protesters, is adding to the cost as we speak. But I'm clear that we are within budget.
You say you're doing this on behalf of taxpayers, but you can't tell them how much you've spent on this operation?
Not at this moment, no, because I'm not going to guess. I'm not going to make an estimate, but we are within budget. But
can I just add to that? Can I just add to that? If we did not take action, people would quite rightly ask, what price law and order in this country? Because you can't pick and choose when it comes to the law. You can't have the law for the travellers and another law for the local residents. People would say, what price law and order if we didn't take this action? It's a matter of principle as much as anything else.
Excuse me, next question, please.
Radio 5 Live, would you accept some sort of responsibility for this? Because this has been dragging on for 10 years. Right at the start, you could have nipped this in the bud, but you didn't.
I don't know if that's quite true, because we did issue enforcement notices. Those enforcement notices were quashed by planning applications. We then had John Prescott give the travellers 2 years to move off, and in that time the site mushroomed in size. We then came back in 2005 and went through the planning process all the way to the House of Lords. So I do accept responsibility for the policy, and we're here today, but not no blame.
Thank you. Mike Sargent, BBC, please.
We know what we can do and we know what we can't, as we know there's different enforcement notices on different plots. But we've said, and I'll reconfirm today, once the operation begins, which it has begun, it will come to a conclusion, and we will make sure those enforcement notices are complied with. It will take as long as it takes.
Where will they go? Where will they go?
Well, we have made them aware in the past, their representatives and the travellers, of unoccupied authorised sites throughout the country. And we have offered bricks and mortar accommodation to the vulnerable elderly and the young. There's no need for them to live by the roadside. That would be their choice.
Have any of them taken up bricks and mortar?
As of this moment in time, I'm not aware they've taken up any of the offers that the council have offered them, either pitches or bricks and mortar accommodation.
But they are aware of authorised sites that are vacant around the country, and they've said that they don't want to move there. As Tony has said, they've also been made aware that there's alternative accommodation here, but they don't want bricks and mortar. And don't forget, the council has obligations to look after the young, cater for the young, the elderly and the vulnerable. So the council has done everything it can. It's a question now of making sure the law is enforced.
Folks, I have one more question before we go over to the police. This gentleman, please.
Well, they have been aware, and I can speak personally, that Candy Sheridan, one of the representatives, made aware of site 8 pitches at St Helens, to which her response to me was, we're not going to move to Liverpool.
Thank you very much, folks.
There were others.
I'm going to hand you over to the police now. Thank you very much.
Good morning, everybody. Yep, Superintendent Trevor Rowe from Essex Police. Yes, surname R-O-E.
Can you give us an assessment of your operation and how far you've gone this morning in trying to maintain order around the site?
Yeah, just to give you an overview and an understanding, we've obviously been in negotiation with the protesters and the travellers, certainly active yesterday and even early this morning to try and bring a peaceful resolution to this situation. Clearly, it remains a Basel and Council-led operation to clear the site. Our intention is to clearly prevent any disorder. The situation with the information and intelligence that we'd received over the sort of build-up to this was that a lot of missiles, fluids, objects and liquids had been stored. Intelligence clearly suggested there was going to be a serious disorder if obviously entry was made into the site. Based on that situation and that information, the tactic was obviously to try and gain safe control of the site as soon as we could. Obviously the tactics employed this morning were to rapidly cover the site and get control of the gantry. That provides us with the most risk to members of the public, the travellers and certainly the protesters, just because of its very nature. That's where we are this morning. As you will see, we are in control of the whole site. It's calm, the tension is now reduced. And obviously the bailiffs are now within their operational parameters and are starting to actively take steps to clear the site.
Can you tell me how many people were tasered and how many people have been arrested so far?
There was an isolated incident this morning regarding taser. I think that's well documented already. What I would say is that serious violence was offered to a pair of officers in particular. Their response was to protect themselves. They carry personal protective equipment, which included the taser, and they just naturally reacted, as they are trained individuals, to operate that device.
ACPO recommend that tasers aren't used in public disturbances.
Absolutely, as a public order tactic generally, they are not recommended. However, this was an isolated incident where officers were threatened directly. And I think you will see that within the footage that's been captured today. We haven't experienced that many difficulties this morning. We treat everybody with respect and dignity. There's been a clear delineation between the travellers and the protesters this morning. The majority of the majority of the violence was clearly come from the protesters, as we understand it, and obviously we've had to deal accordingly.
Was it a protester who was tasered then, or a traveller?
That is still subject to investigation. I'm not prepared to talk too much about it. As you can understand, there will be an inquiry, and any issues around reasonable force will be looked at as part of the investigation.
And the travellers claim that undue force was used.
Sorry. BBC Essex, the travellers claim that undue force was used.
I'm sure they will claim that. Obviously, there is a continuum around reasonable force, and the law is very clear on that. All officers that are trained in these kind of situations, to be deployed in these situations, understand that very clearly. That's part of their training, so they know what the boundaries are and what the limits are.
And how many arrests are you looking at?
Well, I think it's very clear that we are here to protect the police and obviously make sure there's no breach of the peace. Where we've got information, intelligence, as I said earlier, that there is going to be significant serious violence with the storage of weapons, liquids and fluids, then we've got to prevent injury to members of the public, which includes the bailiffs, which includes the council, as well as members of the public, including the travellers and the protesters. So clearly that's why our intention this morning is to get early control. As you can see, there's been no officers injured today so far. We've got calm on the site. We continue to negotiate and hopefully support and assist Basel and council in clearing the site lawfully and peacefully.
When did that situation change? It's been obvious.
Would you call this a success, LBC?
Obviously, that'll be analysed after the event. We're still in the early stages and it's too early to comment. As far as the police concerned, we've obviously gained control very quickly. We've got caught calm. We haven't got disorder. And as far as we are concerned, we're satisfied at this time.
How many arrests have you made?
At this time, we've got 3 arrests that have been made.
Radio 5 Live, could you just give us a few more details about what was happening to your officers before they took the decision to use their taser gun?
As I said earlier, I've given you the information that I'm aware of at the moment. That will be subject of investigation anyway, as any use of force will be, and I can't obviously comment on that anymore.
What do you say to the residents of the site who say the police have been smashing down walls on plots that should be legally protected, and that in fact someone was attacked trying to explain that to an officer with a baton?
Okay, our clear intention this morning was to gain control of the gantry, as I said, in terms of safety, safety of officers and the public. The other issue, because of the nature of the operation today, was to provide emergency access for all emergency services. But to that end, it was necessary for operational reasons to create that entrance and exit for both fire, ambulance and obviously ourselves. That's the main reason for the removal of any property or damage to any property, which again will be resolved after the issue.
Can I ask
two more questions, please?
Was it always the plan for the eviction to be police-led?
No, as you well know, it's a Basel and Council-led operation. We've been negotiating for obviously a considerable amount of time as a Basel and Council. We wanted to obviously deploy peacefully. It was a good day for Essex Police if we didn't have to get involved. And actually the travellers left the site was cleared in line with the law. That would have been a good day for us. Unfortunately, events have taken a little bit of a turn today, but we now are in control. We have a peaceful situation and we want to bring this matter to a lawful conclusion.
So the travellers say that they expect
that your officers would have had this morning, did that include anything that said that it was okay for them to taser in a public order situation such as you had today?
Clearly, operational briefings are confidential and that's something that we won't disclose at this time, this early in the operation.
Have the IPCC been in touch yet or not?
And again, this is too early to say in terms of any referrals that need to be made to the IPCC.
Can I just ask one more question from 5 Live about the people on the gantry? How are you going to get them down? It's very precarious up there.
Absolutely. It's a tactical decision for the tactical commander. What I would say, negotiation plays a large part of that. We will continue to negotiate and we'll obviously try and end it peacefully without injury to any party. Okay, thank you very much, anybody. That's the comments from Essex Police today. I'll hand you over to the ambulance service.
BBC Essex at the live press conference here at Dale Park.
Gary, can you identify yourself, please?
Yeah, Gary Sanderson, spokesman for the East of England Ambulance Service. Gary, you're 1R.
Right, Gary, can you tell us what the situation is, the number of casualties and what you've had to be involved with this morning?
I can confirm that we've had 6 casualties today. One woman has been taken to a nearby hospital with a back injury. 4 further casualties have been assessed for difficulty in breathing problems, smoke inhalation and a nosebleed. We just received another call to one patient with chest pains. And out of the 6, 4 have refused to go to hospital and we're still dealing with one casualty at present.
Can you tell us more about the back injury?
The back injury was on site. We don't know how it occurred, but it's classed as a minor injury.
Reports of someone having a heart attack, is that, can you confirm that or not?
No, we haven't had any calls that anybody was suspected of having a heart attack at this time.
Have you been able to get the access you want to people in there?
Yes, the access has been very good. We've got our hazardous air response team. They're using a Polaris buggy, which was called a golf buggy this morning, which is clearly not the case. It's an advanced piece of medical equipment which will take heart paramedics into the scene, deal with the casualties appropriately, and it can bring them out safely to and away to an ambulance.
How many crews have you got on site?
We've got a deployment of our heart team. Ambulances from the surrounding areas are on standby. We have tactical advisors, clinical advisors on site, liaising with the police and the other services that are here today.
How would you describe the well-being and the state of mind of the patients you're dealing with?
The patients have all been fine, very cooperative. You know, obviously our immediate care is their priority, and thankfully only one has been taken to hospital, which is very good.
Thank you.
The lady we took to hospital was sustaining a minor back injury.
How many of the injured tested for how many travellers?
All the casualties, all the six that we've been treated as tests, have all been on site.
Do you know whether they're protesters or travellers?
No, we cannot confirm at this stage if they're travellers or they are staff. Thank you.
Cool.
Cheers, thank you.
Well, there it is, the ambulance service talking about six casualties they have treated so far. Before that, the police talking about obviously the tactics, which I'll come back to, but saying the tension now there at the site is reduced, so much so that the bailiffs, and we saw a truck just going in, actually taking steps now to clear the site, and talking about three arrests so far. And we heard detail about the tactics this morning. The council saying there had been persistent negotiations. Many of the people, the travellers, had gone. Those left this morning had made it clear they had no intention of cooperating. And the intelligence they had was that they were likely to come up against violence. They talked about stockpiling items to use against the police when that operation started.
The leader of the council, Basildon Council, stressing he takes no satisfaction from the events of today. He says, we've spent 10 years trying to sort this issue out through negotiation. John Barron, the local MP, the Conservative MP for the area, says they are now asking the travellers, the residents, to ask the protesters and the other supporters to move on. The police, Essex Police, saying that, in their opinion, the majority of the violence so far today was actually coming from the other protesters and supporters rather than actually from the residents of Dale Farm itself.
And asked about the tactics, both the council and the police, about undue force. That was the allegation from the travellers. Well, the police saying that their officers are trained in this. They know what the boundaries are on reasonable use of force, saying that the action they had taken was proportionate. And still, the MP was asking the travellers at the site to actually move off this site. And the council saying that, as Jane was saying, it was never their intention that we should see scenes like this, but after 10 years of negotiating, we are doing the right thing, said the council leader. And they detailed some of the things that have been stockpiled and the things that have been thrown at police, missiles, powders. They talked about urine and concrete, and saying that is why they reacted in the way they had this morning. The taser incident, the police were asked about that. They talked about serious violence was threatened to two officers, and that's why those tasers, you've seen the pictures of that this morning, that's why the tasers were used. And there you see the digger that has moved into place. In terms of underlining what the police were just saying to us, that actually there is an element of calm there now at the site, enough for those bailiffs to actually get in there and actually take their first steps at what they're trying to do here today, which is, of course, to clear this site.
Just in terms of the cost as well, inevitably there were some questions at that news briefing about the overall cost of this. Tony Ball, the council leader, would not be drawn. He simply wouldn't come up with figures, although he did say several times this operation is within budget. He said it is within budget. He said, of course, there will be extra costs incurred because, as he put it, the protesters and the people there at the site were dragging this process out. Therefore, by definition, it was getting more expensive by the day. But he said it is nonetheless within budget. And the local MP was standing alongside him at the time and said, what price, law and order? Essentially saying that this had to be done as a matter of principle.
One final thing to tip-eyed legal